Y'all, this is Deontay the Bronze Bummer Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Face facts, what up?
RealFansRealTalk.com, where orthodontist Trip Young and intern Tom for the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
Well, log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda. Certified cosign. You know what I'm about, son. RealFansRealTalk.com. I'm out. One. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com.
Oh, welcome back to another live episode of Real Fans Real Talk. It's been a big week in sports, and this is an even bigger episode because this is our NBA Finals preview. Y'all know Game 1 is on tonight at 9 o'clock right after we get off the air. So I know y'all happy that y'all can get y'all Real Fans Real Talk fix on first and then shoot over. We're going to be at around the corner watching the game afterwards because, you know, it is Cleveland, the king. LBJ will be playing tonight. But before we get into the finals, let me introduce my co-host, Mark the Statman Skevich.
What's going on, everyone? Very excited. NHL Stanley Cup Finals, NBA Finals going on at the same time. Great time for sports. A lot of stuff to talk about. And, of course, we got a family member of the Real Fans Real Talk team joining us once again, the one and only Anthony Mason Jr.
Hey, what's up? What's up, guys?
You know your family when you make it onto the intro.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's what I usually do because we're family members, you know.
Exactly. Oh, man. And, of course, we got the official Real Fans Real Talk blogger, Eric Sanchez, a.k.a. Legend in two games. And obviously, it's a commercial break going on right now.
You're going to bring in that wrap it up, yeah. B.
But,
you trying to wrap it up?
But we got all right. So we're gonna start with this. What's going on?
I'm surprised. You know, I left the introduction for Eric for you because I had a feeling you wanted to take some shots at him off the bat. But I guess we waited a little.
Well, you know, the commercial break kind of interrupted me. But you know,
you did bad.
Okay, he did have you did your Eastern Conference and your Western Conference picks and whatnot. Now you picked. I don't know what in your mind would lead you to believe that the Raptors of Toronto could beat the Cavaliers of Cleveland.
Hold on, now, you picked, like, did you just say, yo, Toronto's winning the East?
That's what he said.
He did say that in the beginning before.
I picked him from the jump, obviously before Valanciunas got hurt. But I liked him from the jump.
I like their team. I like their defense.
That's good spirit for them.
Yeah. You know, now, did Drake pay you to make that pick?
I'm not even a Drake fan, homie, really. Like, I like Lowry, though. I like Kyle Lowry.
I do too. I just didn't think, you know, that they had a chance in hell of beating the Cavaliers.
That was one of them Cinderella things. They was having a great year.
Yeah.
I mean, how do you say they have a chance? They took two out of three in the regular season. They played them tough in the regular season.
Regular season and the playoffs is two different
things. I understand that. So then don't use that argument tonight, then. With Golden State and Cleveland, because
they beat Golden State, beat Cleveland. So I would use that same argument because it was regular season. So I can't use that argument. It don't matter. Plus,
who you got
Kyrie,
tonight? Who we got
Kyrie
tonight?
Has been healthy. Oh, tonight I got the Cavs, and I got the Cavs in six in the series.
Okay.
Because Kyrie is healthy, man. They said, he said he hasn't felt 100%. It wasn't until like the last 3 weeks of the season when he felt 100% with that, coming off of the knee surgery. And it's definitely showing right now because he has been balling. I think he might have had one bad game in this playoffs. But other than that, Kyrie has pretty much been on. Kevin Love, for the most part, has been on. He had a couple of bad fourth quarters in two games in Toronto. But other than that, Kevin Love has been playing well. Shannon Frye has been, you know, looking amazing coming off the bench. Probably maybe the best acquisition, this season because what he did for the Cavaliers, spreading that offense out, he kind of gives them that Chris Bosh effect, not to that extent, but as far as just being a person that could, a big man that could knock down threes, playing the four or the five.
I think that was a good addition too.
I know. I'm you know, Shumpert, he's healthy this year. Everybody's healthy. That's the main thing going into this series, is that the Cavaliers are healthy. So this is going to be a completely different NBA Finals than what we saw, you know, last season, when it was pretty much the LeBron James gang. Now we actually, you got the big three, and they're playing basketball the way that they pictured when they brought these guys together. The chemistry is working well right now. You know, we're not hearing all this excess stuff outside of the game. Oh, LeBron got issues with Kyrie. He got issues with Kevin Love. Like, everybody is on the same page right now. J.R. Smith is playing defense. He's actually gotten better.
Only thing, they can be a problem, though.
Well, J.R. Smith playing defense?
No, because everything's so good right now, you know, and they just got into their wave of goodness in playing that great, you know, this year, when you got a team that's been successfully been playing this way for two, three years now. That's the only fault I would say into that. Not saying, like, you know, just getting hit in the mouth.
Yeah.
When they take their first hit, how they going
to
take it?
Well, they took their first hit against Toronto. When they,
yeah, I'm talking about a Golden State hit.
They took the hit.
Yeah, that's not a hit. They've been breezing. Yeah, they haven't took a hit this whole playoffs.
Golden State, when they matched up against the Thunder, they're like, oh, wait a minute. We're not walking all over these guys like we are everybody else.
Can they make that a readjustment?
Cleveland hasn't had any real competition. Toronto is a good team, but not on the level of OKC or Golden State. The
only thing I'm going with is LeBron, man. You can tell me Kevin Love is better and Kyrie, you know, is 100%, but it's going to fall on LeBron. But, well, and he's been playing great,
to be honest. Don't win this series if Kevin Love doesn't play the way he's been playing the last couple of weeks. He has to step up the same. Like, because we know LeBron is going to do what LeBron does. I mean, we saw what LeBron did in the finals last year by himself. So we know what LeBron is capable of, and which is why I really like the way they ended off the Raptors series, because it was pretty much LeBron making sure that Kyrie and Kevin Love were involved in doing what they needed to do. But when it came time for that closeout game, game six, we saw LeBron James, the best basketball player on the planet.
That's what I'm saying now. That's what he has to do. If he continue to do that, for sure. The only thing, they cannot get into their ball that they've been playing lately, honestly. Like, they can't get into a shootout with them.
Yeah, no, not at all.
I hope they don't carry on that three-point shooting thing going.
They got to get in the lane. They got to push the tempo. Facts. If they settle on the threes and fall in love with shooting 30, 35 threes,
it's not going to be
a game. It's not going to happen. That's not a game plan that's going to work here. And I think it's a little bit more than Kevin Love. I think Shumpert got to play better. J.R. Smith has to show up. J.R. Smith was absent the whole finals last year. He's got to play back.
He definitely. Fry's a good adjust. I like Fry. Fry's big. And that's the thing. But not saying, like Eric just said, you definitely need J.R.
You got to have those guys.
And here's the thing. You have, you know, now, where last season, there's an extreme amount of pressure on J.R. Smith in last year's final, because no Kyrie Irving, no Kevin Love. So now J.R. Smith can pretty much just focus on playing defense and knocking down the shots when he's open or when he
sounds
get those shots, because you know you have to guard these, you have to guard Kevin Love. You can't leave him open because he will shoot the three and he will knock it down. You have to guard Kyrie Irving. Last year in the NBA Finals, Golden State was very fortunate to not have to guard either one of those guys. I mean, Dellavedova, I like him, but I mean, obviously he's no offensive threat. You're not worried about that. So now you have to actually worry about Kyrie
and Kevin Love are not defensive threats at all.
Well, I mean, that's why
the only thing. Well, it's a good series, man.
Love against Green to me is the key. Because if Kevin Love just struggled defensively against Draymond Green, then they got to change their whole rotation.
Yeah.
He's got to play him really tough.
Yeah.
If not, then Love comes off the court, and now that changed the whole dynamics of what Cleveland wants to do.
I think Lou, I like the structure and the way Lou, because we were talking about a couple of days ago about Lou, Coach Lou, and how he has him playing. Just the structure of the team is way more, is way better now.
I agree. And I don't think he got enough credit. For
yeah, because you don't see that. People, fans don't see that unless you know the game of basketball. You know how the ball was rotating and how the offense was flowing before that, and now how it flows.
Look at Kevin Love.
Look at the numbers. The numbers is a balance across the board with the numbers.
Yeah,
and they got them trusting each other more. He's a point guard, so you know.
And they got everybody is involved right now, 1 through 5. You know, so this is going to be. This might be the best NBA Finals in a couple of years now.
What you think about the playoffs in general? I think this has been like
This is definitely one of the best playoffs I've seen
In years, right? Battling-wise.
Yeah.
In the East.
It was top-heavy, but then as we got close to the finals, the game just got better.
Yeah.
That OKC-Golden State series was great.
It was great.
One of the best ones we've seen in a long
Golden State
time.
Come back from a 3-1 deficit.
I mean, it was great, but the way they fought, it wasn't like it was easy for them, too.
No.
They just was a better. I think like Golden State is just a better team overall. Like I said, when you've been playing that long, that well, they great together. And like I credit like listening to the Inside the NBA show, and they always talk about how they never change their game plan.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably what happened with OKC and Golden State Warriors. Golden State Warriors, they play Golden State Warrior ball night in, night out, no matter what. You know, if we taking that loss, we'll take the L. But they're going to be playing their type of ball night in, no L.
Absolutely right. And that's why they were able to come back from being down 3-1 because of that. They stuck to Golden State Warrior basketball, and OKC just did not have the answer. And it's, you know, I don't know if it's they lost the trust in the rest of the role players because, you know, in the beginning of the series, they were trusting guys like Robertson, and then, you know, towards the last couple of games, and it just became the Durant Westbrook show.
Yeah.
Where they were just
shooting.
But as
much as we want Westbrook to be a PG, honestly,
he's not.
You know, if he had a more skill, but it's like he needs, like he knows how to pass, but the knowledge to make the pass now, and I need to score now, here and there. It's just like his aggressiveness and his passion for the game takes over his play. So he's like that kid in the park, like, I got to win, like, let's go.
Yeah.
And sometimes, and I feel like in this series it happened a couple of times. And then with KD, I just feel like you just need to feel like the world feel. I don't feel like he feel like the world feel like you're KD.
Yeah.
You're Durantula, boy.
Yeah, I mean,
kill these people.
Speaking of which, I wanted to bring up the fact we always thought Kevin Durant, it was his team, but the way Russell Westbrook has been playing, almost average, you know, with triple-double after triple-double, is it still Kevin Durant the better player on the team?
I feel like I guess that's a conversation for us. I feel like they shouldn't even worry about that. You know, it's our team. You know who you
but we're on the TV show. And it is a conversation for us.
I guess, you got to say that. You got to say that. I feel like, it's Westbrook's, but he's the general. He's a point guard.
Yeah.
And like you said, the way he's been playing and how he's been leading, you will have to say when you come up in the highlights of Westbrook and OKC.
I think deeper than that, I just think it is Durant's team, but I think Westbrook is the engine to that.
Mm-hmm.
You need a guy like as passionate as Westbrook to make that go. Because Kevin Durant is so laid back.
Yeah.
Without Westbrook, they are not the Oklahoma City Thunder. They're not the same team. So I think you need them both. They go hand in hand. It's one of those rare duos that we see in the game where one feeds off the other and vice versa.
I just wish that Kevin Durant was a little bit more vocal and kind of taking over the game more so when it counts, because a lot of times Westbrook in the fourth quarter is controlling everything that goes on. If you look at like just say, because when we talk about that point forward position, if you look at the Cavs, you know, like LeBron is going to be bringing up the ball in certain situations, and Durant can do that as well, but it's just, you know, Westbrook turns it into the Westbrook show a lot. And I'm not mad at Westbrook, because I actually thought Westbrook did really well in the series. I mean, almost averaging a triple-double. Yeah, you had a couple of timely, you know, costly turnovers, but he actually did play really well in the series. I mean, both of them did. Durant missed a lot of shots those last three games. Two of the last three games, he missed like 40 shots. But, I mean, for the most part, I thought they played well, but they stopped trusting in the guys that really helped them to get to that 3-1 lead. And then that, in turn, caused the guys to start lacking in confidence, because, I mean, it was a point where Robertson was open. He wasn't even trying to take the shot. He was just straight passing.
It was at that one play. But, I mean, you got to give credit to Golden State.
Yeah.
They played excellent basketball.
And they didn't quit.
They didn't give up at all.
Nah, Game 7, though, Anthony's right. In Game 7, they lost trust of the guy. If you look at the minutes, they only played six guys in Game 7. They did not go into their bench. Kansas saw less than 10 minutes. Robinson didn't take the shots. He only went 2-for-11 in that game. But they didn't go to Foy. They didn't trust any of their guys off the bench. And they strictly went Westbrook and Durant down the stretch.
Yeah.
So now we got to look at
it
the coach.
Was a little bit. Yeah, it was a little bit of trust there as well. I think it was Westbrook and Durant, but I think it was also Billy Donovan. I think he felt like, these guys ain't gonna get it done. So we just gonna give you guys the ball and you run the show.
Yeah, I think after the, you know, being up 3-1, and then losing games 5 and 6.
Put you in panic mode.
Yeah, he went in panic mode. Especially the way they lost
game 6. Yeah. You up 7 with what was like 5, 6 minutes
at
ago?
At home.
Yeah. That's yeah,
if they didn't win it in game 6, I pretty much knew. Yeah,
everybody knew that.
Yeah, going back.
When you lost that game 6, it was like.
Game 7. It was just bad because it was like, yo, because we sat here last week. We're like, yeah, this thing is pretty much over. OKC, they're going to come back to OKC and win it. And now Golden State, like you said, they did not quit. And she took it to game 7. Once it goes back to Golden State for game 7, that's it.
Yeah.
You know, so.
We're going to take a fan mail question. Francis from Daytona writes in, who do you guys think will be the X factor for each team in the NBA Finals?
Well, I
like Iggy always.
Iggy? Okay.
I like Iggy. And honestly, I'd be feeling like if Harrison Barnes never got hurt, the way he was playing ball in the beginning of the season, if he can bring that back for these finals, that'll set them apart. And for the Cavaliers, like I said, I like that addition of Fry. But on the defensive end, if JR can lock down his position and jump, and they knock down those jumpers, I feel like that spread for the Cavaliers. Like that JR, Fry, and Shump, they play well. I feel they'll help them out extremely.
Who you going with?
On the Warriors, I think it's Sean Livingston. He's got to keep the second unit playing the same way the first unit does. If he plays well, I think they're going to be really tough. And then on the Cavs, I completely agree with Mace Jr. It's Shump and JR. Man. Those guys, they got to play big on the defensive end, and then they got to contribute on the offensive end as well.
I definitely agree with E2 about that Livingston thing. Livingston is their general. He does keep a motor going for that second unit.
And even when when Steph was out, Livingston played some great basketball.
Oh, he played his ball. I didn't know he – like that, and hats off to you, Sean, because it's tough to come back from those injuries, especially the injury that he came back. Yeah. And then playing the level of basketball you are.
Yeah.
Like people don't get – it's a lot – you can get blinded behind Clay and all them, but he's playing for a championship team and pushing that second unit. So.
Yeah, and he's playing very well. And he's definitely not a slouch. And that's one thing about Harrison Barnes is he kind of gets lost behind the Splash Brothers.
I feel like it was the injury this year, though.
But he see, and this thing, because they're already talking about now whether they're gonna bench him for Iggy in the finals. I don't know what's gonna go on with that. I mean, we saw last year that's what wound up happening.
Ended up
eventually
working out. Yeah, they changed after I believe game 3, and they changed the whole series around. So I would imagine Iguodala will start this time around too. So I would think that he would be the X factor as well. I agree with Mace on that one.
Yeah.
And again, on the other side, I say J.R. Smith.
He's got to play. He's got to play that defense. You know, if you can somewhat, because you're not going to stop Klay Thompson and Steph Curry. Like this shooters, they're still going to shoot, but you got to manage. You just can't give them anything that they want to take. So if he can do that, and then still hit a shot or two on the offensive end when it's that time. Don't do anything erratic because he kind of falls asleep. Like, if he's – once he's not doing one thing well, J.R. Smith, he has that erratic Westbrook tendency where he'll just be doing, whatever. So he has to play. And I think he will this series because, like I said, it's just – it's completely different finals. The pressure's not on him. I mean, we were talking about last year, he's the number two guy on the team for the Cavs without Kyrie and Kevin Love. This year you have Kevin Love and Kyrie, so there's a lot less pressure on J.R. Smith, so he can kind of just do what he does. And he's been playing some really great defense throughout the playoffs, so I think he will do well. Well,
the Cavs fans all mentioned how Kyrie and Kevin Love weren't there last year, so it's a different team, but the Warriors are a different team too. They're, we talk about the chemistry with the Cavs being there. The chemistry is even better with the Warriors this year. I mean, we're talking about a historic 73-9 season. So,
still pulling history down 3-1.
My official pick, since we haven't gotten to that yet, Warriors in 7. Eric, we didn't get your official pick yet either.
I like the Warriors, but I think this is LeBron's best chance with this unit, with Cleveland. But I like the Warriors in 6.
All right.
Fence walking. I got friends.
I think you said the Cavs earlier on the program. This is LeBron's year or something, or you didn't make that, wasn't your official pick.
Thanks, Stat.
I'm just checking.
I'm just a fan of basketball.
See, here you go. Come on, man.
I'm not a better, so I'm, it doesn't matter.
No one's betting.
Yeah, we don't know who you're taking in the series.
We were both wrong last week about OKC. Yeah. We said, you know, Golden State would win game like five, and OKC would take it in six, but, you know.
I love the Cavs and the way they're playing right now, but I just haven't seen them get hit this playoffs. Like, I haven't seen it, and I feel like the Warriors team is just, like, so complete, especially coming off now, and their confidence soaring. Got to. They happy to get back in this battle. I'm going to go Warriors in, right. like, six.
All right, three against one on the panel.
Do we need to ask Anthony?
No, he said the Cavs in six.
And
I would love for LeBron to win the chip.
I'm not worried about it.
This story is crazy.
Like I said, you did pick Toronto to beat the Cavs.
I did.
So, and that since you're picking Golden State, that means that the Cavs are definitely going
to. But I already had Golden State at this point, too.
But you didn't have Cleveland, so it's now it's a little bit different. So now we're going to see.
He's going to focus on that one.
I'm just saying, you know, you win against my man, King James.
That's the thing. You hear that? That's and crazy. I feel the same way. Going back. Against King James.
Yeah, I also had Oklahoma City beating San Antonio. Nobody was picking that either.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to get an NBA Finals bracket than a March Madness bracket.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, that is true.
I think most people would have picked that this would be the finals that we would see. They might not have picked OKC to beat the Spurs. Yeah. So I'll give you that one because everyone thought it was going to be a Spurs-Warriors Western Conference final. Yeah. But
they probably would have four-pieced them, too.
Yeah. They just couldn't run anymore.
But I'm confused with finals. LeBron, I don't want to give it up for LeBron. He's been playing great basketball. And the way the energy's going, like, this is the end of that big story.
Yeah. I honestly feel both sides
have history. You have, you know, a first championship in Cleveland's history for the Cavaliers, and then you have the 73-9 season, which will go down as, you know, a failure on the other end. So, I mean, if you don't complete it with a championship, it doesn't mean anything.
It's going to be like when the Patriots, you know, went 16-0 and the Giants stopped them. That's what it's going to be like in this situation. I'm telling y'all, man, King James is coming.
But you know what's crazy, though? Yesterday, as I was thinking about it, like, you know, it's going to be a good series. Then, of course, they show that Believeland documentary. So it gets you thinking, like, maybe it is their time right now.
This is it because, I mean, like they're actually going into this thing healthy. Mm-hmm. And that's something, like, it's hard for any team to make it through a complete season and then go this deep into the playoffs and everybody is healthy. But they're healthy. And they're getting boosts from guys like Richard Jefferson. You ain't even seen Richard Jefferson playing since the Nets days. And
It's over. Cavs in six. May said Cavs in six. Cavs in six.
Richard Jefferson, you did it again, man.
That's a fact. Cavs in six.
All right, so now we bring back down 2-2.
Not worse.
So good.
Very easily swayed
there. Yeah.
It's Richard Jefferson, man. It's all about Richard Jefferson.
That is the new X Factor.
You say Richard getting in boy face?
I've never seen
Richard like that in my life.
Exactly. He's trying to get a ring. That's going to be the new Shane Battier.
All right, we talked about Kevin Durant before. Obviously, they didn't win. And now Kevin Durant, free agent. Derek from Bay Ridge, Brooklyn writes, where do you guys think the best place for Kevin Durant to sign is?
OKC.
Yep. Stay in OKC.
If we talk about the check, it's definitely OKC because we're talking about him getting $200 million
this check
in a couple of years.
And the best situation.
But if he wants to get a ring, I don't know if OKC is the best place. Because they gave it up. They was up 3-1 in this series. I think this is their peak. This is going to be it. They're not. So he might as well, if he's trying to get a ring, he needs to go to another team.
But where would that team be? He going
to
hop on.
San Antonio. He's going to hop on the San Antonio.
The Warriors, too. Yeah.
You don't think they can get back to this position next year?
Well, he can't beat them, join them.
Yeah, well, that would just look bad on KD. But if he went to the Spurs, it's like, all right, we beat them. They couldn't do
it. Look bad on KD. Who cares about looking bad? LeBron looked bad going to Miami.
But Miami didn't win the NBA Finals the year before that, and then he joined
Miami.
They won
it like 3 years before.
That's a little, but they didn't have, they barely was making the playoffs.
It was like, they did, but
that was a complete, they didn't make the playoffs the year before that.
So you don't think OKC can make the playoffs again next year, into the finals? With that same
team.
Make
it to the finals with Golden State?
Same team.
Is Golden State going to be the same?
I'm just saying. But they'll make it.
Both teams are going to pretty much be the same.
That's what I'm saying.
But that's a legitimate argument to stay. I'm not going to. Nowhere else he's going to go and go to the finals next year.
My question is.
Well, that's what I'm saying. If he goes to San Antonio,
unless you jump on that Golden State of San Antonio wave, where are you going to find a running mate better than Russell?
Nowhere.
That's what's it. That's why I said the Spurs.
Yeah, that's
be the
a big
player.
Unless, you know.
And that's what's it. Unless you're willing to go to the Spurs, that's, or Golden State,
that would give him the best chance to win a ring if he went to the Spurs. But now, staying in OKC, I don't. If, they were in the best opportunity this season to go to the NBA Finals, and they gave up a 3-1 series lead. I can't see them getting there. Past Golden State next year. They're only going to get better.
Yeah,
next
but
year.
I mean, you could say the same thing. I mean. Oklahoma City had a couple young guys that developed. Cancer got better this year.
You feel me? That's their first year there. Yeah. They got a whole nother year to stay together and come back.
Yeah, he Cancer did get better.
Let's work out these kinks.
If you go to Golden State, the dynamics of that team change because they ain't going to be able to keep Draymond, Clay, bringing KD. What about Steph next contract?
Well, they're gonna. The thing is, right now, it's the Harrison Barnes. I think he's the one that's up, and that's gonna be the big money getter. And I'm pretty sure he's coming for a check this year, especially if Golden State wins the finals. There's no reason for him to take less money to stay with Golden State. He's gonna want to get that.
They'll
get that
be
money.
Okay with letting him go if they sign Kevin Durant.
Well, if
KD leaves, he's going. If he leaves anywhere, he's going east.
Did he go to the Knicks for Statman's sake?
Nah, that was my next. That was my next thing. I was gonna interrupt you guys, and then I'll say this honestly: the best place for Kevin Durant to go.
But you gotta take Westbrook too.
New York Knicks.
If you take Westbrook,
merchandising, how other people bring along, they got some cap space. I mean, that's a big three already there: KD, Melo, Porzingis.
You just wait, resign. You know, do the 1 year or 2 years with the option, and then that way next year, him and Westbrook come to the Knicks. Then that'll help you.
That works out for me.
I'm trying to get you something. At least get you back to the playoffs, man. Something, because this is bad. What's going on with the Knicks, man? So
I wonder anybody. Yeah. That ain't never happened in history. Two star players go to the next team, the same team.
Yeah. Not in their prime. Yeah. We don't get them in their prime.
Yeah, that'll be crazy.
We get them when they done.
That ain't gonna happen.
That'll be crazy. Nah, I think if he leaves east, I think his best option is to stay though. Like, why not? You just made it to the finals this year. Like he said, you got a young cast of young players that's been playing hard and working.
I tell you what, he could go in the East though and actually
need a new coach.
Have a position to win a ring is the Celtics. Because they have a really good team, a young team. They got a couple of first-round draft picks this season, and they got a lot of cap room. So they could bring Kevin Durant in and then get a couple of guys.
I don't think his structure on that team is different.
I don't know. I think you know, it could be different. A dark horse, though, because they already got pieces in place.
Yeah.
Portland too. There you go. You got your point guard too.
Yeah, you got a backcourt already.
Different.
Yeah.
You go there. They're a playoff team, a very young role playoff team. You add KD.
Yep.
That's crazy. Yeah.
And he can go there and that can shake things up.
Yeah, that's a difference.
That's a great one-two punch. And they got the money to they could actually bring in a decent big man to run with that team too. So actually that could work too.
It's gonna be the decision part two.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Or part three, I guess. But definitely,
would he announce
huge. Well, he's not going to do like LeBron.
Oh, real fans, real.
I think everybody.
Yeah, he'll be right here.
Can we get KD here?
Easy money sniper.
KD, you know, you can come sit with us, and we'll have the NBA season preview, and you can pick which team you're going to do right here live on Real Fans, Real Talk. That's probably the best thing anyway.
That makes the most sense, especially
if he's announcing that he's going to play for the Knicks.
Well, then it definitely makes sense, in that
come
situation.
Out to Brooklyn and make.
I mean, we're here. You know, we're willing to have you. You know, I know you're coming off the loss, but we're not going to hold that against you. You come here, make the decision, and it's all good. All right, but we have a lot more to get into on this show, and we're gonna jump to over the Ballin' for Peace because we got the Loaded Lux interview that's coming up, and when we come back, Ladybug is going to be joining us, and we got more on this NBA Finals preview. Real Fans, Real Talk. Make sure y'all following us on Twitter and Instagram at Real Fan Talk, Facebook.com/Real Fans Real Talk, and YouTube.com/For The Fans Productions. Make sure y'all hit that subscribe button and check out all the interviews.
What's happening here? It's your boy Loaded Lux, you know, show when I'm rolling up. You're now tuned in to Real Fans Real Talk live. Me.
RealFansRealTalk.com. Where Arthur Diamond's Trip Young and Intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stat.
All right, what's going on, Trip Young? We back, Ballin' for Peace.
Now, this is a very special interview, because you're definitely going to get this work after this interview. But I got to go back right now, flashback Monday, because the first time I interviewed Lux was at BronxNet a couple of years ago, and we got the chance to chop it up. And that was before the Calico battle, before the rematch with Mook, before the Hollow battle. So now we back.
We talking dirty too, man.
Yeah, Balling for Peace. Well, first, we're going to start off with Balling for Peace, and we're going to get to the battles in a second, but we're going to start with Balling for Peace. What brings you to Balling for Peace?
My man H2O, for real. You know, he's been doing these joints, and, just going to have a good time, man. I love the city. I love my home, so, you know, that's why I do that.
Now, are you going to be bowling today?
Nah, probably not, though. Listen, I ain't going to lie. If bowling was my thing, yeah, you know what I mean? Like, if they was out there bowling, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
All right. Now, we're going to jump into a little bit of the music, because you did come out to Black Dawn a couple of weeks to Haran's event in Queens at Black Dawn, and you performed there, and you definitely shut down the stage at that point. I know you were sick, but you still went up there and did your thing.
I had to. You know, keep them dates going. I'll keep my word. Did that Talk Dirty joint. That's the next project on the way. Got a lot of dope music coming out on that. I mean, if they already didn't got Beloved too. I think that was the one that proved that, they got that stigma that, you know, you come from the battle circuit, so you can't transition to make the music, which is a big misconception. They can go get the project, see that. I got Wiz Khalifa on there. I got Kevin Gates on there, Fat Trail. I got Gunplay on there. I got Ab Soul on there. You know what I'm saying? I got some joints. I got Anthony King on there. Winners on there. Dose on there. I got some joints.
Right. And then you did put out now, Rihanna did put out the song, You Don't Get This Work. You did the remix. Now, did Rihanna give you the copyright on that, You Gonna Get This Work? Because that's yours.
No, she didn't say the whole You Gonna Get This Work, but I am on some commercials. There's some different things floating around there where You Gonna Get This Work. So, you know, we got all that copywritten, trademarked, and all of that. So, got lawyers on the case as we speak. You know, but listen, more importantly, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, your business is just a means to be here while we living. You know what I mean? So you got to take care of that, you know, just to, as far as the system is concerned. But on another note, you know, I mean, how proud are we back at the camp, though? You know, we believed in the sun, we was doing it, and, you know, it woke the world up to a degree. You know, people, you know, they say you're going to get this work, and I love it because, you know, hard work the only thing that works, man. Whatever the situation is, whatever you're doing, whatever your pursuit out there is, you got to work to get it in. You got to be willing to do what it takes. You got to commit. So, more importantly, that's what I'm on.
And you definitely been putting out a lot of music as of late. But I think my favorite joint is still Santino. Like, I think that song was one of the hardest songs. And this is not just in music, period. Like, that song was so hard. Like, that's still my favorite song to this day. But it's definitely about Beloved too. And now back into the battle ring right now. Who's coming up next?
For me, as far as competition is concerned, I don't know. That part I don't know. I just love what I do, and I try to like go out there every night and when they see me, I'm giving my all. You know me. And if I ever fell short of that, you know, we went back, licked our wounds, figured out the game plan and how we could do it better. So that's my thing. That's I don't know who yet, as far as, you know what I mean? But we working it out. People know who been gunning for me, who had my name in their mouth. And, you know, it's come up in plenty of conversation. You know, listen, man. More importantly, I'm going to do what it takes.
Now, the person, I think the number one person, and this is not who I want you to battle, it's who I want you to kill. Just because I don't like the fact that, you know, he tries to always turn this into a New York versus St. Louis thing. And I don't even feel like he's really on your level. Like, I don't think it would be even close if y'all two battle. But I just want y'all to kill Verb.
He got my name in his mouth, right? Yeah, they do that a lot. It's cool, though. I love it. It's flattering. And at the same time, you know, still sharp and still. You feel me? I'm on it. I truly am.
And then the other two names I'm going to throw at you, Jersey, Sue Surf, and Arsenal.
Yeah. Dang, you got two from Jersey, huh?
Those are the top guys in Jersey right now. So, and I can't just put you in the ring against somebody who's not even on your caliber.
Yeah, they got to be at least talked about. I've been asked about Surf. You know, I don't mind Ars, you know what I mean? You know, it's tough because it's like, we know the sport, you know what I mean? And for me, what it is to go in there and do what it takes, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes when you have relationships, I've learned, you know what I mean, to block out or at least try to center what's necessary, the space you have to be in to do the work, you know what I mean? But it's like going to a, you know, it's like they're still little bros, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And that's the relationship. Now, as far as the work is concerned, as far as, you know, what we do in there, that's a whole nother level. So, yeah, I mean, it can happen.
All right, well, listen, we want to know what's going on.
You said all of that, Lodi. But you said at the end what I wanted to hear. That's all I wanted.
Well, out of those three, who you want to kill most?
Out of them three?
Yeah.
Damn, I mean, well, I got to do verb, man. I like, listen, you know. I ain't seen us.
That's the one I really want to see. And like a couple of years ago, he was talking about the top five from New York versus the top five from St. Louis. And that never actually went down. But could you set something up like that through the Lions then where you ought to be the captain on the New York team and Verb has the St. Louis, and then who would you put on your top on your team?
I don't know. My top five of New York dudes?
All the New York dudes, top five.
I don't know.
That you were put to go up against to represent New York versus St. Louis.
I can't get on that. It would have to be like we on the brink of going in that thing. Like, it would have to really literally be like 6 months until the day of or something like that we know is coming up, and then I can give you my strong five. Look, this shit shoots and ladders, man. I'm not going to lie. Should be up and down like the stock market. You know how it go.
Yeah, definitely. Now, the last time, you know, after the last Mook battle, you said from now on you was taking the gloves off. Does that mean we're going to see round three versus you versus Mook, or is this just whoever, anybody is going to get it?
I mean, everybody going to get it, you know what I mean, as far as me going in there. And why I said the gloves was off, I see that personal lane is up for grabs, you know what I'm saying? And people is respecting it, I mean, and they going with it. I can't act like that ain't the playing field. You understand what I'm saying? That's what it is. And you can't cast pearls amongst the swine, you know what I'm saying? I can't take that, you know what I mean? Humbler for the rumble approaching there. They coming to kill. So as far as that's bottom line at this point, but you know, we still going to be tactical. We still going to think. We still going to put that thing together the way it's supposed to be done in battle rap's truest form of how to do it, you know what I mean? But, you know, I see how if that's what it takes to have the audience a little bit more attentive to what's being said, well, we'll use some key points that may be personal. But at the same time, we're going to draw from those a good conversation, not only to touch on, you know, personal characters as far as my opposition, but it may, hence Calico, be relative to people in the audience as well, you know what I mean? So they need to hear. And if that's something that gets them like, well, then let's go for it. But as far as the me and Mook thing, you know, I'm a competitor. I'm a, you know, that's me, you know, in my nature. And that competitive force, that adversity has been creating progress for me. So, you know, before the books is closed, you know, if it make it happen if Mook is up to it. But to say that it definitely does have to, you know what I mean? It don't. I mean, we as far as the record books is concerned, you know, we can't take nothing away from neither one of them.
I think a lot of people have the first battle as being debatable. And then, I mean, you gave Mook the second one as well. But I think if there is a third one, it has to happen on Smack. And, you know, we spoke to Beasley last week and about this whole it doesn't count if it's not on Smack, which is why I think it needs to happen on Smack. So Mook is talking about some outrageous, crazy large numbers right now. So if they can actually do that, I would love to see you guys have round three on Smack. But in the meantime, we do have Summer Madness coming up. Have they talked to you yet about that?
Yeah, they've been talking to me.
can you tell us the names they've been throwing at you? Come on, man. You got to give us the scoop, man. This is real fans, real talk, man. The people want to know.
No, definitely. I mean, I've been in conversation. I mean, listen. Because if you avid, you probably know the conversations and what people been talking about. So I love to keep you in suspense at this point. I mean, because you know, could either be one of those prospects, you know, potentially.
Now, and you said recently that before the Calico battle was a choice between either Calico or DNA, and you chose Calico, which worked out probably is better than you could have imagined. That battle, as far as just like coming back for you and saying I'm still one of the kings of battle rap. So, but would you take DNA now?
I don't know. See, here's the thing. Since I came back, whether they know it or not, and that's the funny thing. Other than the Mook battle, every battle since I came back has been one to check off the list that had to get done, because away from side or behind the cameras, it's been talks in the air. You know, and I was hearing those firsthand, like. So that's why all of those got done. You know, as far as from Calico on. So I love for it to make sense, because I mean that's like anybody. If you going off a hunch or you going with your heart, that's how that go. Like, I'm not going around here just picking on people. I don't want that type of reputation. Nah, I don't want that. It should be, you know, we even kill and you want to do something and I want to do something, and from there may the best man win. But I ain't picking on nobody.
Okay. Well, out of the new guys, who's your favorite up and comer right now?
Out of everybody doing anything? I always told people I like Av right now. I had to say, I just watched the Av and Rum Nitty joint. I had to say Av is rookie of the year so far to me. I can't say that for B Dot as far as, because that'd have been like, you know, my other choice, but I can't say B Dot is a rookie to me. You know what I mean? I've been seeing him since last year. Just put it on. You know what I'm saying? So.
So yeah. What about that battle? B Dot versus Loaded Lux.
Now I've been asked that, and then they come back with it. I feel as though, you know, the B Dot question comes up a lot because of the conscious angle and how that plays on it. Like I said before, the conversations for me have to be thought provoking. They got to make sense. If we battling. It's because you take a position and I take up a position and we're going to debate about, well, this is why I feel as though my angle is better. I feel as though you can't deal with me here because of this point. I haven't found that premise with B-Dot. I feel like we're on the same mission, to be honest. You understand me? Now, if we're just talking skill level lyrically and all that, then I don't know if that's grounds for a battle, because you already know what battles is at this point. It's soul digging, so it's, you know, it's personal. So at the same time, I feel as though, and I'm being true, I have to be a true artist. I know a lot of people want to see a lot of different matchups because, yo, it's just him, man.
They just want to see you kill everybody, basically. Now, all right, one last battle that I would like to see happen from you, because he has been saying your name every so often. Every time he get a chance, so he says your name, is Disaster. Now, would you battle Disaster, and would you battle Disaster on King of the Dot?
I can see that. I ain't mad at that. King of the Dot, I've been trying to figure out where in my career I'm going to get to that. You know what I'm saying? I went over there, I hollered at him. And it was brief. I came to a battle. And, you know, it was just trying to figure out who and when. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, that Disaster does sound like a good name, though.
Yeah.
He has been talking.
Because, I don't know, because it would have been, I don't know, past day, I hollow battle on past day, so I don't know, I kind of.
So that means Lux versus Disaster.
Look. I'm never going to say it's not possible. You know what I'm saying? Because you already know. Everybody side-eyeing everybody in this joint. Like, yeah, I rock with you, but at the same time, I clip you too, so, like, you know.
We're going to have to set that up to be the official Real Fans Real Talk called Loaded Lux versus Disaster, because that's the battle that I really want to see.
Hey, man, listen. As far as I'm concerned, everybody get it. Everybody get it, man. Any given Sunday.
That's definitely what we'd like to. Oh, last question. So what do you think about all of these cliques and battle rap? Like, everybody teaming up and want to join and forces. Like, do you think this is good or bad for battle rap?
I think we can also always learn from one another. You know what I'm saying? I don't feel as though there's nothing wrong with you know, coming together, seeing different people's way of doing things and you know, forming like Voltron, so to speak. I just haven't found, me personally, anybody that's, you know, in that space that I like to go in. I just feel like it should be true in your creativity, and you got to find that. We got to, like, come together and really be as one putting this work together. And if it ain't going to be that, then the shit going to sound like we reading it.
Yeah, I got you. And so nobody that you would do a two-on-two with?
I'm not saying that that's impossible, but we got to have a meeting of the minds, you know, truly, and like really try to go there with it, you know what I'm saying? Somebody asked me about the beat. That's how about me and him doing a 2-on-2?
That would be kind of sick.
Only thing is, B Dot is in LA.
Yeah, so one of y'all would have to either fly out and be for a little while, because you can't just jump
in. Can't, you know what I'm saying? We got the shit and build. It got the, like, I'm once it go out there, it's out there. I can't get it back. So.
All right. Well, look, we definitely appreciate you taking the time out, Lux. Like I said, it's been a couple of years since we last spoke, but it's always a pleasure chopping it up with you, man. Appreciate you coming on, man. You already know.
Tell them I am Loaded Lux on everything, too. IamLoadedLux.com, Twitter, Instagram. Follow the movement. It's moving.
Real fans, realtalk.com. Where Arthur Diamond's Trip Young and intern time. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. Real fans, realtalk.com. Got it. All
right, everyone, we are back live. Real fans, real talk. Mark the Statman Skevich alongside Trip Young, blogger Eric Sanchez, and of course Anthony Mason Jr. And
it's the interlude, Statman. Don't even worry about it. You know, on the album, you gotta have the interlude every so often.
Understandable. And social media, you can't relax. Ladybug is in the building. She's gonna have her rumor mill. So everyone,
that was my intro. Y'all just that was my little, you know.
Oh, okay.
I got that now.
You got your own theme music.
Yeah. They just tested it out just to see, but that was really for me.
I like
it. Okay.
Yeah, that's nice.
But before we get into the rumor mill, just want to remind you guys, especially those procrastinating. The Brooklyn Pizza Eating Contest is this Sunday, hosted by Rocco's Pizzeria and Restaurant. There's only a few days left to qualify. I know we've been talking about it. I know some of you out there have probably been thinking about trying to do it and just procrastinating. Time's almost up. The event is this Sunday. If you want to qualify, head over to Rocco's. You got to eat a pie within 8 minutes. If you don't eat the pie within 8 minutes, you just have to pay for the pizza. If you do, you qualify for the contest on Sunday. First prize is $750. Second place is $350. Third place is $150. So you could basically eat pizza and possibly win money at the same time. So definitely not a bad deal there. Make sure you check them out, Rocco's Pizza on 5th.com. And of course, the NBA Finals is starting right after Real Fans Real Talk, so you can get your order in for your food as you watch the game. But without further ado, the one and only Ladybug has the rumor mill for us.
What's going on, guys? You know, I like to come up and keep you guys posted on what's going on. So I wanted to touch up on this Damian Lillard thing. Now, if you guys go on realfansrealtalk.com and follow my vlog, you'll see my original vlog basically saying how Damian Lillard has been, you know, dabbling in his music career. And now a small update is that Little Romeo was spotted out, and he's called Romeo now, but people still know him as Little Romeo. Romeo now says that, you know what, he's interested in signing Damian Lillard to No Limit Records. So, you know, in the original vlog, you see that he was, you know, getting a lot of interest from major labels, and, you know, Romeo just put his two cents, like, hey, I can talk some numbers with him. I don't know how many numbers.
Oh, he got some money over there. Man, no, yeah. Master P got some bread. So,
he's going to have to drop a lot of dimes on that one.
Yeah.
So you know, definitely check out on realfansrealtalk.com the original vlog, and I'm gonna keep up with that because I want to see what he says. Maybe he's gonna give a response, we don't know, but you know, he's gonna wait for the season to wrap up. He might make a choice, we don't know, but that's something I definitely am gonna look forward to. Now going into this craziness, and now I want to call it craziness because half of the stuff I can't even say right now because this was just over my head. But Tyson Fury was in an interview recently, and basically he was talking about Trip Young knows. Basically, you know, he had an interview and he was talking about some upcoming, you know, people he wanted, you know, to fight in the ring. And he said, you know, if he ever comes up, you know, happens to be in the ring with these people, it's going to be a whole different thing. Like, the whole interview went left. And, you know, he basically brought Deontay Wilder's name into it, and it just got real vulgar, and it's vulgar to the point that I can't even say what he was saying in that video. But it was just,
well, to give us the PG version for the
it
show.
Was very sexually explicit, so for the show what? I'm gonna have to think of it.
Mike Tyson
he didn't say he was gonna eat his children.
No, he definitely you know, said that, you know, he was gonna, you know, bend him over. And you know the rest.
Oh, Mike Tyson was
talking about the other one.
His name is Tyson Fury, not Mike Tyson, but he gets it from the Tyson. But you know.
Basically, we're going to put that on the list of things that one grown man should not say to another grown man. First, and y'all see who let off the show, Deontay Wilder, so y'all know that's family, so we don't even play around. You can't be talking about the family like that. I'm already, you know, myself, Stanley, he was pissed off at the Wilder's Spoker fight at the end of the fight when he jumping around the ring like a buffoon, you know, just acting crazy in the ring, and I can't wait until he meets Deontay Wilder's right hand, and that boy gets laid out because he's just doing too much.
Yeah, and it was just not. It was just like, no, you don't have to be a fighter. If he just said that to anybody, you deserve to get knocked out. Yeah. Like, it was just that. It was just that vulgar to it. It's like, I'm not going to let you finish your sentence. Because
I think that's up there with the guy that slapped Shane Mosley's girlfriend on the butt during the press conference. Here you go. Yeah, I think those are on the same level of things that you do not do before a body.
Because it's just, you know, he ready. He
what
looking.
After that?
he got his butt whipped in the ring after that.
By Shane Mosley?
Yeah, Shane.
Knocked him out.
Yeah, knocked him out. Knocked him all the way out.
That's
crazy. You don't slap the next man's wife, girlfriend on the butt. Don't
in a press conference.
Yeah, don't let him find out.
Yeah. You got to do it alone.
I'm wrong. See, this always happens when I sit down. None of this was said before I came here. See what happens when? Yeah, wrong. Yeah, wrong.
It's ladybug, you hurt?
No, we're not going to do that. No, we're not. This is all before the show. It's crazy. Definitely follow us, Real Fan Talk, on Instagram, because you'll see. It's crazy. Anyway, So I don't know if you guys heard about it, but Ricky Williams actually opened a marijuana-friendly gym. And basically, it's in San Francisco, California. And the gym, the members are encouraged to use a specific dosage of marijuana to boost their workouts. And, you know, this has been going on. I think the gym has been open a few years now. And James Woods was actually spotted out. And, you know, the paparazzi called him and asked him, like, hey, you know, would you ever join this gym? You know, and he's like, oh, no. No. Like, you know, I guess he said that he can't imagine someone, you know, consuming any type of drugs and trying to work out because, you know, you're exerting energy and you're doing things like that. But, you know, Ricky Williams and, you know, his people were saying, hey, this is strictly, you know, it's monitored, it's only for the members, you know, it's a specific dosage based on, you know, their, you know, goals and, you know, I don't know. It's just, I don't know. How would you guys feel? Like,
personal pot trainer?
Like, you know, basically.
Have a one-on-one consultation.
Okay, come on. Yeah, you training.
After a workout is one thing, because Arnold Schwarzenegger used to, you know, smoke after a workout to eat a lot, you know, so that
smoke
way.
Smoke marijuana?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you know, first of all, hats off to Ricky Williams for finally getting the chance to live out his dreams. If y'all know Ricky Williams, one of the best running backs in the league.
That does sound like a dream come true for him.
And he cut his career short because he wanted to smoke marijuana. So at least now he's making money from smoking marijuana. So hats off to him for that. As far as the whole smoking I don't know if they're actually smoking it or if it's like an edible or whatever or just the oils. But I'm not sure how that whole thing works out. But if he's getting a check from it, I'm all for it. That's what he wanted to do. He wanted to smoke. He left the NFL as one of the top running backs so he could smoke. So
It's possible, man. I mean, it's in moderation. If you do anything that's, I guess, over and over again, like something like smoke, because I can say this, when I played overseas, my teammates at halftime would take a cigarette and smoke. Like, so I don't think it has anything to do with your workout. I don't know what it does as far as, like, the health.
I don't see how it can help either, though.
But I don't see if it's, I wouldn't say that it's wrong.
Well, as I said, it depends on whether, because I don't know if they're smoking it or if they're eating it or how they're,
you know, how they're consuming it. But it's basically that it's a set formula, as if it was like a protein shake or as if it was any type of, you know. So I guess, you know.
Use it for a lot of things.
Yeah, it's just, that's the big controversy now. Like, are people really going to take this as, hey, this is a part of my workout, or, oh, this is just a smoke break, and then I'll get back to it. You know, you don't know what actually happened. You know, maybe if,
that's,
you know, anybody athlete, ever though, sees it.
That's,
but
James Woods, he didn't do it, but Jimmy Woods probably.
Maybe he just doesn't know if he can combine the smoking, you know, with going to the gym. He probably didn't know how the whole thing worked out. So
if
that's,
it's open 3 years, right, and people that's coming, hey, I'm pretty sure it's working out to a certain extent. Exactly. For sure.
So I don't know, and you know, in California it's legal, so it's, you know, they're not doing anything wrong. You know, this is all, I guess it has to all be through some type of, because it's a establishment, so it has to go through all these permits and clearances. So
I never even heard of it, but it's California, like you said, they legalize.
Google it, I guess.
So why not open a weed gym?
It's still federally legal, so everything's got to be cash. They can't open a bank account and everything. So
So basically, those are my topics. Exactly.
Come true for Ricky Williams.
Success at its finest, but definitely keep up with me. Exactly. Yep. Keep up with me throughout the week on social media and realfansrealtalk.com.
That's right. And we're jumping into the final thought segment of the day. Usually we let everybody go, but I'm gonna kick it over to Anthony Mason Jr. so he can tell you guys where we're going to be at on June 11th and on June 12th, because there's some big things going on with the Family on 3 charity, as well as your dad getting the street officially named in his honor.
Yeah, this weekend, June 11th and 12th, two events. June 11th, this is a street renaming ceremony starting out around at 10 a.m., 147th and Rockaway. It's my pop's old neighborhood. Earlier this year, around October, we petitioned for it, wrote up some, and Councilman Will's office and Senator Leroy Cumbry's office helped me out, and now we got it approved. And now we're doing the ceremony on June 11th, 10 a.m., so we're going to be out there for the kids, have a couple of games, floaties. And then June 12th, the next day, my organization, Family on 3 Youth Enrichment Program, we're doing a kickball charity game for the kids. We got some kids coming up from the Philadelphia area. Well, a couple of my ex-teammates, Sean Evans, he's a part of this organization called Family Over Everything, FOE, and them, they're NBA players out of Philly and pro basketball players that started a company. So it's two young black organizations, you know, bringing kids together for the inner city community. We're doing a kickball game at MCU Park. So pull up, $10 for the kids, $20 for the adults, free food, prizes, and get to meet the celebs.
All right. And with that being said, for myself, Trip Young, Mark the Statman Skevich, Eric Sanchez, Anthony Mason Jr., and the lovely Ladybug, we will see you guys next week, and we'll be discussing what went on in this next couple of days with the NBA Finals. But right now, we're about to go watch that game. RealFansRealTalk.com. Yes, make sure you check us out.
You are.
Good night.
We out of here.
Real fan, real talk. You are.
Yo, that's next weekend.
Next weekend.
Nah, you told me this weekend. That's what I'm saying. I beat it. I'm going to go.
Oh, June 11th as well.
RealFansRealTalk.com. Where Arthur Diamond's Trip Young and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend the CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. Hey. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Did Jeremy Lin hurt?
Well, log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only...